In other news, Lincolnshire Police are still searching for missing teenager Leah Gibson. Police are growing more concerned due to the teenager's last seen whereabouts being several days ago.
This so-called society we live in has become blinded by their own insecurities, not realising the dangers which surround them. The streets are plagued with vermin, as if a disease has contaminated the world and all that's pure. I'm an isolated person, but every time I attempt to leave this house, I become more isolated and even more and more detached with this society, realising the lack of decency which smothers and strangles this world. Women have lost their self-respect, so determined to gain attention. They remind me of a dying gazelle taking its last steps in the wilderness, with the men acting as vultures, circling their prey, ready to pounce on this vulnerability. My head aches. In fact, it itches through this fear, anxiety, and anger. I'm becoming more and more agitated by the minute. I can't remember when I last slept. My eyes feel tired, and I feel exhausted in my existence. I am unnoticed and unloved. It's as if it's God's plan for me to walk this world alone. Even a simple task such as buying groceries is a weight on my shoulders, people's beady eyes staring and judging me. She'll never be found, heard from, or seen again. She'll just become a forgotten name, a distant memory, such as I am living now. We're not so different in many ways. We are both here to be forgotten and left to dissolve in time, due to this society's unwillingness to change. Youth of today have no respect for anyone. One step at a time, that's all I need. Take their insults on the chin. I will have the last laugh. They will learn to show me the respect that I deserve. That was the last time I left this house. My head feels like a ticking time bomb, ticking, tocking, never stopping, pounding away in my skull. I've decided enough is enough, and that I'm ready to leave this existence and become remembered. So this will be my last entry, which I'll share with the world. The tiredness, anxiety, is far too great, and it'll destroy me before I can destroy it. Now people remember me forever and ever, allowing my name to live on, making my mark in history.